What's up, guys? Skid Rampage here. So today we have crazy Funko news. A brand new Naruto exclusive popped up on Mercari. Perfect Susanoo Kakashi available at Hot Topic. We also do have brand new Marvel pops like Dr. Octopus as well, guys, as we do have brand new Star Wars pops. It looks like a $250 Christmas grail that was vaulted just restocked at Pop in a Box, as well as much more news. So let's check it out. So welcome back to some more Funko news. We have some crazy stuff to go over. Just recently, a new Naruto exclusive was dropped on Mercari. We also do have a new Marvel pop, a new Sinister Six set available over at Amazon, as well as a new Star Wars set available at Amazon. Like this, oh, this Funko news is fun. We have so many great things to go over. We do have some reminders of some drops tomorrow, as well, guys, as we do have some other new pops and better looks, some delays, restocks, and much more. So a lot to go over in this Funko news. If you guys are enjoying the Funko news lately, if you guys are excited for this video, smash that like button down below. It really helps me out, and I'd really appreciate it. And subscribe and click that notification bell if you are new. I do want to say a quick shout out to all of my patrons. Thank you so much for the continuous support. I really do appreciate that you guys chose to support me and my channel and everything that I want to do here. So thank you so much to all of you. Now we do have a lot to go over, guys, so let's jump all into it. So first up, let's take a couple better looks at some new pops that are coming soon. Now jumping into the Funko news, we do have some better looks at a few new pops coming soon. Coming from Wanted Collectibles Instagram, we do have a better and out of box look at the Toon Dragon here. Look at that menacing like little smirk. This is a really cool pop. It has a metallic look to it. I think it is metallic actually. It looks really, really detailed and cool. I love the page details. Like, you literally have the lines showing how many pages there are in the book. And then you have the kind of, like, the background of, like, buildings, which is really nice. Looking at the back of the pop, you can see the buildings and the wings, which is really cool. And then one of the coolest features on the bottom here, you actually do have it saying Toon World. There's, like, text on the bottom of the actual pop that is the actual base stamp. I thought that was really neat. It's, like, a hidden detail. You know, obviously the pop is kind of sitting down, so you can't see it when the pop is just kind of standing up. If you flip it, it has some really cool details on the bottom. I thought it was really cool that Funko did that, and I wanted to share it. So thank you so much, Wanted Collectibles, for sharing this one, and I can't wait to see this one in person. Here we do have a better out-of-box look at the Captain America Year of the Shield 5-pack that was available on Amazon. Now, I think these were Slapshot Pops photos from his YouTube video, and then Funko Miwo actually did share it on Instagram, I believe, at least. Anyways, it's somebody's photos, but I believe it's those two that kind of, like, shared it all around. Anyways, we do have, like, the several different Captain America pops here. Oh man, this is so cool. I'm so excited to get this 5-pack. I want to add it to the collection. I need to get a protector for it. That's going to be very interesting. This one's supposed to be coming out in January, if I'm not mistaken, but I believe, or January, February, but they got the like special edition one and kind of reviewed it a little early. Look at that though. There's so many different ones. I love the unmasked one. That's probably my favorite, and then, you know, the top two kind of, like, original ones, which are really neat. I don't know, I think this looks really nice. I can't wait to see this 5-pack. If you guys want to see a review on it, I can totally make that happen. If not, no biggie. I want to do more Marvel on the channel anyway, so maybe I'll just do it either way. Either way, this is really sick, and I can't wait. Also coming from Funko Miwa, we do have a better look at the 10-inch Master Chief with Energy Sword, the GameStop exclusive, also EB Games. Still available on GameStop's website if you want to pick this one up, if you do like the look of the pop. So essentially, I believe it's just like one of the commons, just the standard Master Chief with Energy Sword turned into a 10-inch pop. I think it looks really cool. He's obviously a really big character. I believe he's like 7 foot, if I'm not mistaken, maybe a little bit taller, and this makes sense. And like, this is a huge pop, which is really awesome. Either way, I haven't played a Halo game in a while. I've had a couple Halo pops in my collection over the years, but I'm not a big like Halo collector. I do enjoy the games, and I enjoyed them when I was younger, when I did have an Xbox. Either way, really cool pop, and it should be coming soon. We do have a few different updates on certain pops. First up, we do have Rex here, the Box Lunch exclusive. If you guys were looking for this pop deluxe, it is starting to drop in stores tomorrow. I don't know if all stores are gonna get it, because we've had a lot of issues with stores kind of like simultaneously dropping all of their stock. It's supposed to be street dated, but some stores aren't getting all of their stock, unfortunately. So we could see all the stores dropping tomorrow. We could not see all the stores drop it. Just follow your local Box Lunch if you guys do want this one, or maybe chance it in the morning. That's really up to you. But it also does have a good chance of going live tomorrow at 7:45 a.m. PT and 10:45 a.m. EST. So just look out for those times on the actual website. Hopefully this one does drop tomorrow. A lot of people want this one, and it's a really cool one. It's kind of tiny, but it is a really cool. Actually, is this one tiny? I don't remember. I think compared to the box, it looks tiny, but I think it's a decent pop. Either way, I've seen it out of box and it looks amazing. So any Toy Story fan, I think, would really enjoy this Rex. And I think the retail price is $31.90. Is it $30 to $32, something like that. Kind of same with Mini Nezuko, I believe. Either way, if you do want to grab this one, make sure to look out for an online release tomorrow, as well as an in-store release at Box Lunch stores, possibly all of them. Another Box Lunch exclusive hitting stores right now, we do have the Winnie the Pooh brand new exclusive, where he is in rain boots, stepping in puddles, as well as holding an umbrella there. Kind of a cute little pop. It's another Winnie the Pooh pop, unfortunately, but it is a cute little pop. So this one is hitting stores. I believe it's retailing for $14.90. Some Box Lunches have been posting that they have their stock. So again, just follow your local Box Lunches on Instagram so you can look out for all of these drops. Either way, it's a pretty cool exclusive if you do want to go after it. It's kind of randomly dropping, does not seem to have a release date at this moment. Now for my Beauty and the Beast fans, we do have back of the box looks at the brand new Beauty and the Beast wave here. So Bailey's going to be very excited about this one. The Beast one has already been hitting Box Lunch stores, which is really nice. I believe Belle was also releasing the top one in the blue and white. So thank you, Distractors, for the photos here. We also have Cogsworth, Gaston, as well as Lumiere, and another Belle. And then we also do have the little moment of Belle and the Beast here. So pretty cool wave. I think that moment might I think it's a common moment. Either way, yeah, all of these should be coming relatively soon since we're starting to see the pops hit stores already. I don't think there's been an official announcement from Funko, which is really weird if stores have their stock already. So I'm not sure when Funko will announce it. Is there like an anniversary coming up for Beauty and the Beast? Because this seems like an anniversary set. I'm not gonna lie. Anyways, let me know, are you guys gonna pick up any of these new Beauty and the Beast pops? Let me know your thoughts and if you'd grab any. Now, we do have a few different things hitting stores. Thank you also, Distractors. We do have the Walmart exclusive four-pack of Superman, Batman, Joker, and Harley Quinn. And these are all as different little characters, like Superman is Santa, Batman as Ebenezer Scrooge, Joker is Santa, and Harley Quinn as the Helper. Anyways, either way, it's just kind of like four packaged commons essentially into an exclusive four pack. That's all it really is. If you guys want to pick this one up, if it suits your fancy, make sure to check your local Walmarts. Now over at Toys R Us Canada, it does look like stores are starting to get the Blacklight Black Panther T-Bundle here that was in that original wave. We have not really seen them in the States just yet. I think some stores got them randomly with the Target sticker, but I don't think we've seen an official drop to my knowledge. Anybody in Canada, make sure to check your local, Toys R Us stores because you could come across this T-Bundle. For anybody wanting the Diamond Britney Spears exclusive from Urban Outfitters, it does look like she was delayed again, and it doesn't look like she's going to be shipping until 12/29/2021. So again, just to reiterate, she is currently delayed and will be shipping at the end of the month if you guys did order this one. Now, we do have a ton of new Funko Pops to go over tonight. So first up, we do have some Iron Maiden Pops. Now, I'm not really a big Iron Maiden fan. I don't really know any of the characters here, but they do look really, really cool. And we actually do have a new Chase, which is really neat in this new 5-set. This is, like, they're really cool and really detailed. They go crazy with these. I believe they recently had NFTs for these too, which I was surprised. I didn't think it was that popular, but they sold out, which was crazy. Either way, Iron Maiden here, pretty cool pop, so make sure to pick some up if you guys do want to for pre-order. Looks like we do have a few new China exclusives again. Good Lord, they're just going back to back to back with these. We have a Green Lantern Metallic, Wonder Woman, kind of sepia, black and white. Then we also do have Lubu? And Zhao Yun? I'm trying. I don't know. Someone please let me know the correct pronunciations of their names. Either way, those look pretty cool, I won't lie. Like, the repaints and recolored and things like that of the other two are kind of like meh. But these two new ones, they look really nice. Oh, I love that. It looks like a 15-year anniversary sticker, if I'm not mistaken. So very interesting for this one. They keep going all out. Like, everything has stickers over there. Either way, some brand new, con exclusives over in China, and they should end up in the States fairly soon here. This one was a little bit of a random one and kind of interesting. A lot of people were just kind of like, huh? We do have Nasi, I think his name is. I think he's like a icon in Germany. I think some people were saying he's like a streamer or like a news outlet person. So yeah, an icon. I personally never heard of this person. I don't know if any of you guys have. You guys can let me know down below if I have any German subscribers, but very, very interesting. I was not expecting this to be made. His pop looks rough too. Why does he look so tired? I don't know. Interesting. But yeah, it's a EMP exclusive. So if you want to pick it up, go over there. Probably one of my favorite new releases, we did get a brand new Sinister Six set here, and this is kind of like a pop deluxe, kind of connect them all, kind of like the Avengers Assemble. So we do have the Sinister Six, we have Dr. Octopus here, look at this, and it's part of the Beyond Amazing collection, an Amazon exclusive, available on Amazon right now if you guys do want to pick it up, and it looks so freaking sick. I am beyond excited for this one. Hopefully I can collect them all. Unfortunately, it's going to be like $210 to finish the set though, which is extremely expensive, I won't lie, that's kind of insane. Then we also do have a look at the actual whole connected piece here. We have Spider-Man in the front, and then we have the Sinister Six in the back there. I cannot wait to see them slowly reveal. This is gonna be an awesome little moment. Again, it's a little bit pricey to officially kind of like complete the whole thing, and it's gonna take a while because this one's not even coming for a couple months actually, unfortunately, which is gonna suck. But either way, it's really, really awesome. I'm very excited for this one. Again, if you wanna pick it up, make sure to head over to Amazon. Another brand new Amazon exclusive, we do have the Duel of the Fates Darth Maul. So, I actually have seen this scene. It's with Obi-Wan and Qui-Gon where they're fighting Darth Maul, which I thought was really cool. I've seen this scene. See, I know one Star Wars thing. Either way, this Darth Maul pop is amazing. Like, this thing's crazy. So again, it's going to be kind of like another connect scene, which is going to be really neat. Available on Amazon right now to pre-order. I believe this one doesn't come out until April, unfortunately, of 2022. So a little bit far out. I want to say about 4.5 months out currently, which is a long time, almost half a year, which is crazy. Either way, I feel like this is well worth it. And it's probably going to take a year to complete this entire set. But it's really cool. Now, this one was a very interesting one. So here's a screenshot from Funko's app here. And this is Hermie the Elf here from Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Now, this is about a $230 to $250 pop. And it sells anywhere from $150 to $250 on eBay. However, Pop in a Box had some stock, I guess. They found a box. I have no idea. This one is vaulted. And they actually sold some the other day. It sold out really quick. So I don't really expect the value to be affected like crazy if anybody was, you know, caring about this or does have this one. But I was relatively surprised because this is a 2013 pop. How could you possibly find any stock from like almost a decade ago? That's insane. So yeah, or maybe I guess in a recent restock or the last restock they had some, but I don't know. It was a really weird random restock. I'm not gonna lie. Like every kind of retailer has been doing this here and there. They just find these random boxes. No idea. But they did restock it for retail. It was like $9.99 or $8.99. It was something crazy. And a lot of people got a really good deal. I don't know if these orders are going to actually be fulfilled. We will see. But this was nuts to see. And I wonder what else they will find. Hey guys, so I'm actually re-recording this part because I actually did get out-of-box photos from the actual subscriber that had this pop. So I wanted to actually go over the details of pop with you guys like we usually do now that we have out-of-box photos here. So my excitement when I saw this message was just insane. I shared it immediately. Thank you, Pablo, to the one who actually originally sent it. And that guy named Jose actually was the one that actually did have the pop. And he also sent me the out-of-box photo. So thank you both to you. You guys blew up the anime community today with this crazy drop here. This is just crazy. Like, Kakashi Perfect Susanoo, this was rumored originally by Serlent Pops in like a teaser with Asuma, another Sasuke, and all kinds of different stuff. I want to say like half a year ago, maybe even longer, and now everything's coming to light. Hot Topic Nerdette rumored this one, saying that it was going to come to Hot Topic, that we were getting a Susanoo pop, and that a lot of people were like, oh, it's possibly this one, and I was like, you know what, maybe it is, and here it is. Here we are. We have the Kakashi Perfect Susanoo. I think this pop is great overall. A lot of people have their kind of gripes with it. A lot of people seem to have some issues that we'll kind of talk about. Some of the comments I was reading on Instagram. But overall, it is a 6-inch pop, okay? A lot of people are kind of confusing it with the size here in the photo. It's a 6-inch pop. It is priced at $22.90. Now, the funny thing about that price is that Naruto and Gamakichi is about the same size. Pop rides and 6-inch pops are about the same size. I'm assuming because a pop ride is like two different separate pieces, separate molds or something like that, that they piece together and make a big moment for, that's why he was $35. Other than that, I can't make sense of it because this is $22.90, $23, and Naruto and Gamakichi was $35. And that's literally a $12 difference. I don't exactly know what happened here. I don't know what happened to the prices here, but I feel like those should have been backwards or something like that. I don't know. Naruto and Gamakichi is small in its box, and yeah, it's just a smaller pop all around, and then a lot of people had their gripes with the detail, so it was kind of crazy, I won't lie. It kind of bugged me to see that the Kakashi Perfect Susanoo was cheaper, regardless of what line everything is from, because it's the same size box and same size figure. Actually, Susanoo Kakashi might even be bigger than that, And I'm really relatively surprised. Not mad at it. Happy that we're going to pay around 20 bucks for this. It's really awesome. We also do have an early link, guys. And an early link means that we basically have the link before it actually does go live. And that means you can refresh it as many times as you want. And once it pops up, you can buy it. That link will take you directly to that item. Thank you, Funko News, for that link, by the way. That is posted on my Instagram story. So make sure to go follow me on Instagram if you guys do want that link a little bit early. Now, one more thing to note about this is that it is actually dropping in stores. This is kind of random. It is dropping on the East Coast, not the West Coast this time around, the East Coast. And the East Coast store was actually in Tennessee, so fairly close to me. I don't know if that means we'll get stock, but fairly close, which is kind of nuts. I'm very excited to actually get this one. Looking at it, it's really cool. I think they captured Kakashi Susanoo really, really well in pop form. Again, we're going to go over kind of like out of box. Let's look at it out of box really quick. So a lot of people were like, you know, the wings and the actual pop itself, the shaded colors are very different. I agree. It does look very interesting. If you actually do compare it to a picture from the actual show, it's basically all one color. It's not exactly two colors how they did that. I don't know why they used a lighter blue instead of the darker blue that they used on the wings. I think that would have been an overall really, really great color. I think making it a little bit more translucent would have been nice as well, but I think the wing detail is really, really cool on the pop. Seeing it from like the side, you can see the armor markings and like the hair on it is really cool. The mask is really, really cool. Like just the armor overall is really awesome. I think they did a really great job with the actual detail. Again, it's not gonna be perfect because, you know, it's like a little figure. It's a plastic vinyl figure compared to the actual art of the show. It's not gonna be perfect. And we just gotta realize this with these pops. Some pops look really bad though, I will agree. I like this one personally. I think it even looks better than the Kodomo Susanoo. I don't know if anybody would agree with that. I can't wait to compare them. But out of box, this thing looks amazing. I love the wing details. I think they did a really good job. And then you even do, I believe, that shuriken in the hands, if I'm not mistaken. It's kind of hard to see what they are. The finger detail's really cool. The shoes are really cool. Like, even the eyes are really nice. This would have been a really cool glow-in-the-dark pop, and maybe we will see that in the future. Now, also one thing to note, it has a really hard time standing without its base stand. It does actually have feet prongs for an actual plastic base stand. You can lean it up against stuff, but I don't know if it will actually stand on its own. That's what Jose was actually telling me, just so you guys know that. I'm trying to give you guys as much details as we have. We don't have an exact release date. This thing could release online at any moment. Typically, it does have a later at night release. I want to say anywhere from 8 a.m. or 8 p.m. EST, excuse me, all the way until 12 a.m. EST. So like a 4-hour window when this actually can drop. And that's what happened with Naruto and Gamakichi like 2 or 3 weeks ago or 2 weeks ago. But overall, that's all the details we have. Again, price point, $22.90. It is starting to hit Hot Topic stores on the East Coast. Will make its way over to the West Coast. I was talking to Dish Trackers, and he actually did say that West Coast is having issues right now, and all of the stock is being shipped from Tennessee over to the West Coast. I believe that's what he's saying, rough kind of translation. So yeah, West Coasters, you're going to have to wait a little longer for this one. Looks like us East Coasters are getting something first for once, which is kind of cool, unfortunately. But hopefully you guys do get it very soon. A lot of people were even saying, they're like, you know, they don't like these details, but they'll still buy it. Anybody absolutely trashing this pop, you're going to buy it anyways. I know you will 100%, because either whether you're buying it to resell it, whether you're buying it to keep it, just be honest that you want the pop, even though you might not like it fully. You can like something and not like it at the same time, just because, like, you can just like the fact that it was made and like the character, but also not like the design of it. I will say though, make sure to be following your local Hot Topic on Instagram, because you will know based off when they post how much stock they have and when they actually will have this available. So that is a good rule of thumb. Also follow me on Instagram, because I will, you know, post updates as I do get them. Either way, this is a phenomenal pop. I'm happy with it. The only gripe I have, and I agree, is like the color. I wish it was kind of the same color. But overall, I think it looks really good, and I think it's a really great representation of the character, personally at least. Let me know your thoughts. Not everybody agrees, and that's okay. Let me know if you are also going to be picking this up. But I am very excited, especially about the $23 price point. I can't wait. Now, I did actually want to share a really awesome custom. Now, I don't know how to pronounce your Instagram name, I'm not gonna lie. I think it's Shapies or Scappies or Scapies, something like that. Sorry if I butchered that horribly. But we do have this Infinite Deku with Eri Pop glow-in-the-dark feature here. So this is actually a custom job, but I'm really, really hoping that the actual Funko one that is rumored to be releasing fairly soon here looks half as good as this. Like, look at this. He did such a good job. The outlines in the hair, like the glowing and the lines look really cool, and the strands. And you also have the lightning all around his eyes. Even even the parts of his eyeballs glowing. Then you have Ares' horn and her eyes and hair glowing. The lightning all around his feet. And even, it was kind of funny, even a really cool detail was the actual sash that's holding up her, like the ripped scarf or whatever, holding up Ariana's back is actually glowing. This is such a cool pop, one of his best work. I've shared some of his work, I think, in the past, and he sends me a lot of his work. He does a lot of, like, customs and a lot of, like, glowovers, and this one was just too cool not to share. So amazing work. Thank you so much for making something really cool, and hopefully Funko's looks just as good as yours. All right, that is everything that we have for this video today. If you did enjoy this video, smash that like button down below, because Perfect Susanoo Kakashi is here, and we cannot all wait. I know Naruto fans are rejoicing right now, and we are all excited. So smash that like button and show the video some love for Perfect Susanoo Kakashi. That's pretty much it, though, guys. I'm pretty excited for a lot of these. Like, obviously the new Kakashi is awesome. Doc Ock is gonna be amazing. Then we also do have the Darth Maul, which looks sick. Like, it looks so beautiful. The brand new Beauty and the Beast pops Bailey's gonna be super excited about. So yeah, I'm excited about a lot of this stuff. Rex is dropping tomorrow, so lots of stuff dropping in the next few weeks and tomorrow, so it's gonna be nuts. Check your local box launches, check your local Hot Topics, and yeah, just look out for a future Funko news on any more updates for all of this. But again, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. See you guys later. Bye.